Everyone, this is Arcadius, and welcome back to Naval Creed. Today we'll be reviewing the American battleship Illinois. Now, this ship didn't come out that long ago, and honestly, it was already one of my favorite ships before it was even released. Like I said, I've been playing Missouri for a long time, if you watched my earlier video, and this is just like a super Missouri with a couple added benefits. And so I was really, really excited, and when it came out, like my first game was, I did 530,000 damage in just my first game. So this ship is really, really powerful, but it has a slightly different play style than normal American battleships, and we'll get into that in a moment. So first off, I do want to mention it is a matchmaking 9.5, so you will be going up against Montanas and Super Yamatos and all the other top tier battleships versus Missouri, which is only a matchmaking tier 9. So it would go against regular Yamatos, Iowas, ships like those. So you do go up a tier, but you do have some ability to mitigate the disadvantage you would have by being a smaller ship. It does only have 9 16-inch guns, but that doesn't really hinder it at all. It has good speed. It actually has a base speed faster than Missouri of 34.2 knots. It has base health of 88,800 with 32% torpedo resistance. It has 16-inch guns, like I mentioned, that are really fast. Just the same 16-inch guns you find on all top-tier American battleships. However, the main difference is the secondaries. It has a base secondary range of 8 kilometers and a main battery range of 23.9. Now, why the secondaries are important is because you can run secondary builds on other American battleships, but they're not going to be that useful because the angles that these shells come in from hits the main belt and they just shatter because they're just 125s or 127s, my mistakes, they're 5-inch guns. However, with the crew skill attached and with the module for secondaries added on, you can get these secondaries out to like 12 kilometers, and they're actually really powerful because at the angle that these shells come in, they come in and hit the superstructure, and so that's where all your damage comes from, and you set quite a few fires as well. So this ship is a really good secondary ship. It's not so much a brawler, but it does tend to shoot out a bit more damage at mid-range, slight long-range, than other battleships. The armor is still the same as a regular Missouri. However, when you come to AA, it does trade some of the 40mm guns for some 76mm guns, as you can see here. And it does increase the AA a bit mid-range. Brings up to 294 versus, I think it was 234 for Missouri. Let's check. Yeah, 234 for Missouri. So it goes up about 50, 60 or so. Honestly, it's not much of a difference, and I don't really see it. Let's see. You do have advanced damage control. I'm going to go with this one because it reloads faster. You do have regular repair. You also have speed boost. Now, when we get into the game, there's a few things I do want to show you that you can actually have with your ship once you, if you decide to buy her. And it's really funny. But for right now, this ship is really, really fun. She is like a top-tier Missouri, I guess you could say. She's not as powerful as a Montana by any means, but she has a lot more fun. Now, let's hop into a game and show you how she does. All right, and here we have ourselves a game. 5 battleships, 2 cruisers, and 1 destroyer. So no carrier, but that's all right. The perks that I have applied to the ship are quite funny because I have over 100,000 health points, and even though the base speed of the ship was 34.2. With all my added buffs, I can get the ship to over 40 knots. Now, it does suffer in maneuverability-wise because of the long hull, but it's still fun. Like I said, it's basically just a Missouri, except you're up a higher tier, you have long-range secondaries, and you have speed boost. Besides that, you're no different. You swap out radar for speed boost, I guess you could say. And honestly, speed boost is a lot better than radar, because I would use that more often than anything. So here, yep, I have 100,100 health. And I believe I go 40.1 knots in my American battleship. It's the fastest American battleship you can have at this point. 40.3 knots. And that's with all my speed buffs applied. So yeah, this ship is very, very useful and almost unbelievably powerful as well. Add to that the secondaries fire faster than normal American secondaries. I don't know what the fire rate is. We don't get that information in stats, but it is at least twice as fast as Missouri secondaries or Massachusetts secondaries or anything like that. They might not be very accurate. You can be shooting your secondaries for a while and only have like a few hits or so. But the amount of fire that your volume of fire, I should say, is immense. Look at that. My secondaries are already shooting. And you can see that even with a full secondary build, they're not exactly accurate, but you are getting enough hits, and the damage is quite substantial. Because, I mean, Tashkents are not really hard ships to hit, but still. And you can see the fire rate of the secondaries is pretty impressive, and I got two fires on that one ship. And this Worcester would like to be sunk. Your guns are exact same as Iowa and Missouri, so if you have any experience with those, you can easily citadel ships like that. Now you can see they're coming at such a high angle that the secondaries are hitting the superstructure instead of the belt. So that's where they're able to do most of their damage, and they start quite a bit of fires doing that as well. But, as you can see with that Illinois, you still have that weak broadside armor. I was able to get 4 citadels on her, and she was brought down to about 10,000 health. Secondaries are still coming in, but those torpedoes should finish her off. If my secondaries do not... who do I shoot next? Alaska's going to give me broadside. There we go, secondaries finished her off. And let's see if we can finish off Alaska with secondaries as well. Now it's just little 1,000, 1,500, or 2,000 damage for your secondaries each salvo, but like I said, the rate of fire is impressive. And you will easily get a ton of damage with your secondaries. Let's speed boost back into the game here. I don't know where that Missouri went over here. Okay, so they're on the island. Man. You can actually out secondary Bismarcks, which is funny because right now Bismarck is in my base range, but I could still be even farther and still be able to shoot her. And like I said, you aim for the superstructure with your secondaries, so you can easily get quite a bit of damage. The guns themselves are pretty good too. I know I've been talking about the secondaries a bunch, but the main guns are just like you find on the Missouri, and you saw how effective they were yesterday in my video, if you've watched it. I was able to get over 400,000 damage alone in that quick game, and you can do that consistently. That's not just a fluke game, that's a consistent game. Three battleships left. There was not a carrier in this game, so I couldn't really show you how the ship does against carriers, but like I said, the AA is not much different than how you see or in Missouri's case. Honestly though, you could also build her as a full AA ship if you're not so keen on the secondaries, or if you think that 8 kilometers is good enough. Like I said, I only have my AA crew skill applied at this time, so that's why my max range of AA is 6 instead of 5. But if you also went for AA module, you could get that out to about 7.2, I believe. And your mid-range to about 6.3, I believe. I'm not quite sure by the numbers, but it is a build you could go with. Like I said, you are up, you're at a higher tier, so instead of going against Essex and Taihos, you'd be going against Shinanos and Midways, and so the defense against aircraft is very apparent the higher you go. And if you've looked, I've gotten 5 fires just this one game. But I also had 216 secondary hits, or about so. We can take a look at how much damage I did by secondaries versus hits. It's not much, but it is consistent, and that's what's important. And there we go. We have ourselves a game. Now, this ship is a diamond ship, I believe, so you cannot use her to grind free XP, but she's still a fun ship. 340,000 damage, 3 ships sunk, 67 shell hits, 1 aircraft shot down, 11 citadel, 6 fires, 230 secondary hits. So let's look at the damage. Almost 50,000 damage just in secondary hits. That's what... It's about a seventh of the total damage that I did. So, I mean, it's not terrible. It's not the best either. I mean, you have ships like H-42 with their giant secondaries. So you're not going to show or compare to that very well. But as an American battleship, the ship is really, really good. If you want my opinion, definitely purchase her if you are interested in this ship. She's fast, she has good AA, one of the best AAs, honestly. Really good secondaries, good guns. Her armor is not terrible, you just need to know how to use it. And on all, the ship is just really fun. There's not a game that has been boring yet. And it's really fun to out-secondary German battleships. So, with that in mind, I'm going to wrap up this video, and I will see you tomorrow in the next one. Take care.